To create your first project, you first need to click on Create New Project. This brings up the Workflow Wizard. The Workflow Wizard can be used to bundle together all of the processes within PointFuse into a single step from the raw point cloud. However, for the first time, or if using an LGS file, then we recommend using the point cloud option to just import the point cloud into the project first. So I'm going to select on point cloud, choose next, choose a save location, and again, we want to make sure that we've got 5 times the size of that point cloud in available disk space for a successful project. Choose next. And here we're going to choose a point cloud. You can either choose it from the drop-downs on the left or choose Browse to navigate through Windows. If using an LGS file, then there is no import time as PointFuse is able to view the LGS file in its save location and mesh directly from it. You can optionally choose to copy the LGS file into the project. This is a good idea if you're running an LGS file from a network. You can also import any 360-degree pano images, image tags, or text tags at this stage by keeping the option ticked at the bottom here. If not using LGS, then you can import other file formats here, including Recap, E57, and LAS, but there is some time associated with importing those files. But for LGS, we can press Finish, and it will automatically load the point cloud into view. To quickly tour you around the interface, the 3D space is where the models and point clouds that are built within the project will be shown. Along the top, you get a context-driven toolbar that gives you access to a number of different tools. The tools here depend on the type of data that you've got loaded into view at that time. Down the bottom, you get a pink highlighted bar that shows instructions on navigation, selection, and any tools that you have open, and that will depend on the tool that you're using at the time. Along the top are the key workflow buttons, and these will become available as you step through the stages of the software one by one. On the left-hand side is the Project Explorer. Again, as you create meshes, as you classify those meshes and create BIM models, those models will be delivered into this Project Explorer. And finally, on the right-hand side is the Properties tab, which will show properties for whatever is selected, whether that's an item in the Project Explorer or some surfaces of the mesh.